Straight with a Fitness. Thank you for checking out our video. What we're going to bring to you today is just a phenomenal move. In fact, just now, and frequently, we have clients coming in with a wicked kyphosis in their upper spine, thoracic spine, which is causing this rounded shoulder. It's causing oftentimes shoulder impingements, shoulder pains that are associated with it, but at the same time, low back problems. And really, it's not what they like, right? It's not comfortable. It's causing all sorts of problems. So with this kyphosis, there's a number of things that we can do to help with that. Now, first and foremost, a beautiful movement would be to address it via manual therapy and then visit your chiropractor. So addressing the muscles themselves that are pulling on those joints, pulling on those bones, and then seeking out your chiropractor to help with those joints themselves. But one of the movements that helps to increase range of motion within the shoulder joint, which a kyphosis, if we're actually rounding it forward, our range of motion overhead with those shoulders is going to be right here, right? So you can expect, even though their chin's up, their range of motion is going to end right about here. And if that's you, this is a good movement that's going to help with controlling low back and controlling the spine. You're going to hold onto the rib trainer just like so. Belly button in tight, you want your feet about hip width apart. The wider you take it, the easier it is on the core. But you want to brace those abdominals and squeeze those glutes, keep those glutes tucked underneath. Now from a side, you're going to take it all the way down so that the rib trainer, the dowel rod, touches the thighs, and then you're going to take it up overhead. Now if you've got a kyphosis, it's going to limit how high you can take it. However, we're working on building up low back and addressing low back. Now, if you are good and healthy, you've got good full range of motion, ideally you're going to take it all the way to the point where the biceps are in line with the earlobes and back down. That's just a rib trainer front to overhead raise. You want to keep the dowel rod, the trainer, good and parallel to the ground at all times, engaging those abdominals. Of course, stepping it out can really increase the intensity a whole lot. What you often see with this is limited range of motion. That's going to be an issue more likely than not in with the thoracic spine and with the scapula, and not necessarily actually in the shoulder joint. But one of the other issues you'll often see is trying to substitute low back extension to get those arms up overhead. So you can see still here, it's not in line, my arms are not in line with my earlobes, but what's happening is I'm getting that last range of motion through low back. That's gonna cause all sorts of pinching in low back and really weakening up those muscles. So you wanna keep it nice and tight, tall spine all the way through and up overhead, keeping it braced. It's a beautiful, beautiful movement. Again, this is great. If you want to learn more movements and more exercises that you can do to help out any kind of issues, deviations, and pains that you're experiencing, check us out, www.getlitfit.com, or just click that link right down there. Thanks so much. Again, this is Greg with Lit Fitness.